Hello everyone, welcome to the cloud network. In this tutorial I'm going to show you about the firewall D. So I'm going to install and configure the firewall D on CentOS Linux Server 7 is the latest version that I'm using. So that is 64-bit. You can also configure this firewall D in Red Hat 7 Linux, Fedora Server, Oracle Linux or Cloud Linux also. The same method, the same procedure you need to follow that I'm going to show you. You will find every command and steps in the my description box below to my video. So let us begin now. For the first one, starting is for what is netfilter is, first of all, is that as we know, the firewall in Linux one is mean as a netfilter. So why firewall D is so firewall D is a dynamic daemon to manage the firewall with support for network zone. So early version we use Red Hat 7 or CentOS 7, that is called we use with IP tables, but now we are using its latest version as we using IP table in place of firewall D. So latest name has been replaced, firewall D is the new name in place of IP tables. Then we began to recommend firewall D in the using of IP tables disconnect in the future. So using of IP tables in the future has been disconnected. However, the IP table is still supported and can be installed with the yum command. So the same thing, firewall D and IP tables use and the, which may be work on any systems in Linux. So IP table used to configure. In this one, we use input, output, forward, change, which is same the concept we use as zone. By default, there are the zones available for firewall D. So firewall D works with IP version 4, IP version 6 also. Ethernet bridges too can work. So it can be separate runtime, permanent configuration we can do or temporary also. So now let us begin to configure these zones and create our own services. So now I'm going to create a own services plus I'm going to configure the zones also. So first we have, I'm beginning with the, for the testing purpose, this is my configuration is like my OS I'm using CentOS Linux Server 7 and IP address having 192.168.108 and host name is having localhost.localdomain is my. This is my testing environment I am using. For now, beginning for the first of all installing firewall D package. By default firewall be installed in every Linux system. If it is not installed, so this is the command to install this firewall D. After that we are beginning with the checking the status, stop marks, then IP tables. Let us begin now. So first of all I'm going to check your host name and the IP address to login with. Here I'm going to login with the root, so it's better to use every command with the login with the root. So I've been logging the root. We'll check first of all host name, type host name ctl, press enter. So you can see this is the static host name on the screen, localhost.localdomain is the my host name, and I'm going to check in the IP address. Type IP address, give space, show space hyphen grabbed, then you type int in, press enter. So you can see this IP address is 10.192.160.0.10 is the IP address I'm using. So now let us begin. So first of all I'm clearing this one. Now I'm going to install in the IP tables first of all. So to install, type yum install, give space, then type firewall space hyphen y, press enter, and it's going to be, we'll check whether it's going to be installed. So now it's updating and installing, so you need to be wait few minutes here. So you can see this has been installed firewall, and I'm going to now we need to verify whether the IP table service is running or not. To check that, we need to type system, so dot system, give space, status, give IP tables, and then so after typing that one, system.ctld underscore, you need to give a status space IP tables, press enter. So you can see the IP table service loaded, not found, no such in desert. Means that means it is in a inactive mode. So now we are going to check the press above key and just remove the status, and I'm going to type here stop in place of stop. So status, now this you can see the stop also showing not loaded in place of, you know, to type remove the stop, type mask mask mask, press enter. So you can see this is one the IP tables configuration storage here in this location. So now we are going to move to the next. So now I'm going to discussing about the firewall components. So what are the components is we have the step 3 is a firewall CMD. So this is the command to know the components. Then the next term is default zone. Then the step 4 all to view the all zones. And then so here the firewall configuration is drop zone is there. We having black zone, public zone, block zone, public zone, extended zone, internal zone, DMZ zone. These are the home zone, trusted zone. So these are the zones available. So when it comes to the, we'll find out the which zone is available and for default zone and to view the list of all the zone, list of all zone means you need to type firewall. Then you need to give a hyphen CMD, give a space, hyphen get. You need to give a hyphen ZO in your zone, press enter. So you can see the block, DMZ, drop it, external, home, internal, public, state. These are the all zones is showing. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. These are the zones available showing. So now we are going to clear this one and press support key and just remove get into list of all these zones, hyphen all, hyphen zones, press enter. So here you can see is going to be showing about the list of all the zones were trusted. When you scroll down you will find all these zones. So now we are moving to the setting the default zone. Previously we have shown you about the types of zones. Now that we are setting the default zone, so this step 8 one is the firewall CMD. We need to set this is the command, and then we are setting the default zone for the internal plus for the PSC ENP0S3, which is interface zone, which is bounded to check the firewall IP address. So we use this ENPC. After that, firewall CMD get type CMP types, which is supported by firewall. So let us begin now. So I'm going to first of all, I'm going to show you about the firewall default international drops. So type firewall hyphen CMD. Give space hyphen type set hyphen DFA ULT default hyphen zone into give send give is equal to type internal, which we are checking for the zone. Press enter. So it's going to be success is showing. Now we are verifying whether this one is configured or not. Just type a boy key and remove till set to type in place of set get hyphen default. So okay, have fun zone, press enter. So you can see the internal zone has been set. In place of internal you can keep external also and drop. So now we are moving to this ENP0S3, which interface zone is bounded to check. For that one we need to type firewall hyphen CMD, give a space hyphen hyphen get. You have to give hyphen then zone, so give hyphen off hyphen again. You need to type interface here, so check to whether it which interface is on. So that one is equal to you need to give here is equal to you need to give ENP and then you need to give 0S3. So after that you need to press enter. So we'll check whether this has been internal. So you can see this has not been. Then type again for the configuring ICMP, type firewall hyphen CMD, need to give space again, give hyphen hyphen get 2 times, then give hyphen ICMP DYPS types. So you need to type this one, press enter. So wait a minute. So here I made a small mistake, just type here fire E. Press enter. So we'll check. So this has been root. Here I am going to creating our own service firewall. Step is the 10 ones to get these services, and then I am going to insert the folder of the services. Then I'm going to create a cat.nfs.xml file. Then we are moving to the again the this folder is called services, and then we copy this original file dot service.xml into services. Then we'll move to the services again. Then ls to view the file, and then we move this XML RX to be original, and then we reload it, and then we'll get the services this one. one. I am first clearing this one. Now we'll check the list of available service or not. Type firewall and type hyphen cmd, give space, hyphen get hyphen services, press enter to check. So these are the all services available. Now we'll check to get the list of default available services which we use by firewalls. Import type cd, then give slash usr slash lib and give slash here and type firewall d slash services and press enter. So we move to the inside folder. Now I'm creating a file called cat. File name is nfs.xml. Press enter. So you can see this is we need to check this. We need to have port number TCP is connected. Okay, so NFS is okay. So now we'll move to create our own services. Now I'm going to creating our own services. To create I'm adding RTMS to the port number 1935. So first I will make a copy of services. So for that one I'm moving into the cd slash etc slash firewall happen d slash services again. So press enter. So after moving to the folder, I'm copying the making a backup of file of .xml. So type cp the slash usr slash lib, then give firewall d slash services. We need to give here slash xsh dot xml. So give a space, then type slash etc again slash firewall d hyphen svric services. You need to press enter. So this and services file has been taken. I am taking a backup of this services file have been taken. So now I am going to navigate to the folder. So I am going to navigating into the location of the folder which we have been copied to services. I'm going to rename this file .ssh.xml to rtmp.xml. For that which I'm already into the for services folder, type ls to ls hyphen l. So this one is the one file is the .ssh.xml. I'm going to rename this ssh.xml to rtmp.xml. For that we need to first of all I'm moving type mv move the that means rename, that is the file ssh.xml xml. Okay, give space, this is the file name which I am giving rtmp dot xml. Press enter to check again. Type ls hyphen l. So you can see this is the file name has been renamed. I am going to edit this. So here I am opening and edit the file of header. File I am going to edit is .rtmp.xml is the file we need to edit. So after that we need to remove .ssh. In place of ssh we need to type press I here to edit the file. I need to type here rtmp in the short form, and we need to remove the whole description. Just type here in place of description, so like that. You need to remove the file name description, whatever the written in the description is box there, just remove all those things. Already short in place of short we have written rtmp. And so just write here there to allow and type rtmp, give space string name. Okay, after that you need to come down and you need to remove the port number 20 place. In place of 22 you need to give rtpms port number 1935. After that you need to save this file, just press escape and then you have to press exclamation mark WQ to save the file. So this has been saved now. Now we are I'm going to reload the firewall. Type firewall hyphen cmd skip space hyphen reload, press enter. So it going to be reload the firewall. So it has been success. So you can see this loaded. So clearing this one. Now I'm going to confirm whether the service is added or not. So for that one, you need to type firewall hyphen cmd give space hyphen hyphen get hyphen services, press enter. So we check. So this has been added. So you can see RPC bin RPTMS below the above to the Samba and next to the RPC bin RTMP. You can see naturally you can see RTMP is next to the RPC hyphen bin and Samba. You can see, so this one is the RTMPS which has been added. So we will move to the next one. Now I'm going to adding the services, these two zones. To add them, so step 9.1 is the status, first of all check, then we'll check active zones and then we'll see the default zone as a public or not. So firewall cmd to get all the services. So I'm going to clear this one first of all. So now I'm going to see how many firewall is using. So for that one you type firewall hyphen cmd, press enter. So it's going to be not manage options, maybe type a boy key, give hyphen state, press enter. To know about the current status and zone, I'm going to use this running status showing running, type status remove get hyphen active, then give hyphen zones, press enter. So this is your internal ENP-003 is running. And now I'm going to edit the public zone interface ENPSO. For that one I'm typing, for that one just type this command and remove dot firewall config. So here we need to go to see, here is the default public and default zone is internal, which is, so we are, I'm going to edit this file. To type I to edit and remove this internal and type public. So I'm making default zone as a public and then type escape and type exclamation mark qw to save this file. And after that I'm going to clear this one. And now we are checking the firewall services. Type firewall hyphen cmd and give space hyphen get, and to check the services type services, press enter. So this has been added. And to the next, and now I'm going to adding the services to the zone. For that one firewall is a command to get the services RTM. So after that removing the services public, adding this for permanent added, this one is a command 26 the firewall to reload, and then we'll add this IP address to permanent zone, then we can add the port number also adding, and then I'm going to reload it. So after that I'm going to list all this one. So to add this one, first of all I'm going to clear this one. I'm going to create own services by RTPMS services. For that one I need to type firewall, so give hyphen cmd give space hyphen add, then give hyphen services, and then give is equal to RTMP, which is the name we create. So after that you need to press enter and it's going to be added. Now I'm going to remove this added zone. For that one you need to type firewall hyphen cmd space hyphen hyphen zone give is equal to give public give space hyphen remove, then give hyphen service, then you need to give is equal to RTMP. You need to press enter. After that, so warning enable not underscore not enable. And now making temporary or permanent file. For that one, I'm clearing this one. Type firewall hyphen cmd give hyphen add hyphen service and then give is equal to rtjump give space hyphen hyphen amendment, press enter. So that is not the exe. So here I have made again small mistake. You need to give here hyphen like this one. So press enter. So after adding, you see, you can see success have been added. Clear this one. So now I'm going to reload this firewall. Type firewall hyphen cmd hyphen reload. Press enter. It's going to be reload now. After that, we are going to add the IP address now. So for that one, you need to type firewall hyphen cmd then give hyphen permanent then give space hyphen add hyphen source is equal to, you need to give the IP address of this server system 91.60.10.108 is the IP address /24. So press enter. After that, adding. So now I'm going to add the port number. Now I have been added the IP address. Now it has been success. So in place of this, I'm going to add the port number. For that one, first of all, you need to remove this one IP address. In place of source, you have to give port. So just type port is equal to, you have to give 1935 is the port number /TCP, and after that you need to press enter here. So it's going to be added the port number. Now after that, I'm going to reload it, this one. So type this again to reload this command, reload it firewall. So press enter, and I'm going to list this firewall. For that one, remove load, type list and give hyphen all. It's going to be list of all the files. So you can see the IP address which I have been given, the source and interface you can see, and the support number you can see 1935, which is now available. So like you can see, this is one is, so this is my port number is and bit added, and this is my IP address which is in just now I've given. So now I'm going to move to the next. So now adding the rich rules for the network ranges. For this rich rule network ranges, the last one, this is the last one for this firewall one. So this step 31 is to add this rich rule family IP version 4, or you can reach in place of version 6 also. This is the IP address for this default gateway IP address, and the service name I'm adding HTTP. After that, you need to accept, and after that you can also give the permanent for this one. 32 steps to add the permanent only, and the step 33 is to add the HTTPS. After that's the same method, just remove the HTTP and place of HTTPS you can give. So you can give the IP address also, single system IP address, or the whole ranges you want to give, just give the ranges IP address and give the /24. It will come into your LAN network. If you want to give the single IP address, just give the single IP address, and you need to assign the which services you want to give, the HTTP or TCP, FTP. After that, you can make a permanent or temporary, because replace the temporary in place of temporary also you can give. So this is your VNC server also you can give, want to add the family rich rule, and also you can give this VNC permanent also accept. After that, you can give the PostgreSQL also, and the same method, the same, just need to give the only the IP address, and need to give the service name. That thing after this, everything the same procedure. So after that step is done to load it, and then view the list of, we see the list of all this one. So now we'll begin it. For that one, to begin a family rule, first of all I'm clearing. So now I'm going to start this first of all family rule. So for that one, I'm typing firewall hyphen cmd give hyphen add hyphen ric rich and give hyphen rule and give a space and comma ule rule and give a space, type into family, and then you need to give is equal to, and you need to give a special IP version 4, close this one and give a space, type source and give a space address and give is equal to semicolon IP address, that is why I am giving the gateway IP address. In place of this IP address, you can give single IP address for this blogging to a single system. I'm giving the whole network range here, semicolon close, and giving the service name like HTTP. I'm giving the service name is equal to give HTTP. After that, you need to close this one and need to type accept. In place of accept, you can give reject also. You need to press and then close this one. So after that, so after adding, you need to press enter here. So that's going to be added success. And now press above key and just remove here. You need to give here parameter in place of this one. So here, just type above key and give a space. Type here hyphen. Need to type permanent. So after that, you need to press enter. So this is going to be added permanent rule. So after that, press above key and just go for this accept. In place of HTTP, you can give HTTPS. So press enter to add the HTTPS. After that, just go to permanent file and then give HTTPS in place of HTTPS. Press enter after adding all those files. And now I'm going to add the VNC. I'm adding the VNC server. For that one, just remove this HTTP and give VNC hyphen server. Close this one. Press enter. So here also you can give here permanent place in place of HTTP. You can give VNC server like hyphen server. Press enter. So here also you can give PostgreSQL also. After that, press enter, then permanent also you can give PostgreSQL. Now I'm going to see the firewall, and that means I'm loading the firewall. Type firewall hyphen cmd, give a space hyphen reload. It's going to be reload whatever we have been configured. Now it's going to be reload. After reload success, I'm going to list the all. So this is the last command that I'm doing. So in the firewall D, so type list hyphen all, press enter. Now this will check. So here you can see the family rule which is adding here. So rule family IP version 4, source IP address is there, service name HTTPS is accept, and the service VN server also is accept, and you can see HTTPS also is accepting the services. So this is your last step of this firewall D. So if you want to know about the more firewall, type man space firewall hyphen, and you need to give here press enter. Now that means D, press enter. So you can see all description you can read for this manually pages for the firewall D. So my friends, thank you for watching IT Cloud Net video. If you have any problem, if you get any problem, you can comment below to my video. Thank you for watching IT Cloud Net. Please subscribe to Cloud Net channel.